I am going to start vectors today. What are the vectors and vector quantities? Vectors or vector quantities, these are the physical quantities in which direction and magnitude both are present. If you want to define the vectors or vector quantities, then you may define it like as the vector quantities are those quantities which have magnitude as well as direction. If you want to define it by other method, then there is a lot of methods for definition. So I am going to give you another definition for this. The vector quantity can be represented in the form of magnitude and direction. If there is no direction and the combination of direction and magnitude, then we will say this is not a vector quantity. For understanding this vectors and vector quantities, I am going to give you some examples also. Now, suppose first example I am going to tell you what it is: displacement. Displacement. You know that displacement is a vector quantity. What is the displacement? You know that if a person is going eastward some distance, suppose 5 meter. A person going towards eastward 5 meter, so 5 meter east is the displacement. If only 5 meter, then this is the distance only. If we are taking a distance with the direction, then we will say displacement is over here. So displacement is a vector quantity. Velocity is a vector quantity. Force is a vector quantity, momentum is a vector quantity, torque is a vector quantity, angular velocity, vector quantity, angular momentum, vector quantity. A lot of vector quantities are there in physics. Getting it? So initially, vector quantities are those, we have to say, which have magnitude as well as direction. Now I am going to tell you the representation of vectors. Initially, how will represent the vector or vector quantities? Representation of vectors or vector quantities. Then how will you represent the vector quantities like force, acceleration, momentum, etc.? So if you want to represent the vector quantities or vector, there are two ways. One is diagrammatic way, diagram banane ka tarika. So diagrammatic way is what? If you want to represent anything, then you will represent it by arrow. Arrow is the diagrammatic representation of the vector. The length of this arrow represents the magnitude, and this head of the arrow represents the direction. Diagrammatic way, by forming the arrow, length of the arrow will call as a magnitude and the head of the arrow will call as a direction. There is symbolically representation also. If you are representing anything in the vector form, then you will take a arrow on the top of that particular letter. So vector quantity will be represented in the form of capital letter or in the form of small letters too, with the help of arrow. Or another way is also, this is a cap. Clear? So only the representation point of view, vector can be represented by two ways. Diagrammatic way mein arrow, ya fir head ke upar arrow, ya fir head ke upar cap. If there is no arrow, no cap over here, then we will say it's a scalar quantity, not a vector quantity. Scalar means have only magnitude, not a vector. If there is an arrow or cap, then we will say it is a vector quantity. So, got it? Representation is two type. Now I am going to classify the vectors initially in two parts. One is polar vector. Polar vector. Another is axial vector. There are two types of vectors. Basically, two types. Polar vector and axial. So, polar vector are those vectors which have a initial point or which may be represent linearly. If we are representing any vector quantity in the linear form or by the arrow, we will call is a polar vectors. For example, I am taking over here. Suppose displacement. Displacement can be represented in the form of arrow. So, to displacement is a polar vector. Acceleration, polar vector. Force, polar vector. Momentum, polar vector. Velocity, polar vector. Getting it? So, these are the polar vectors. Polar vector can be represented in the form of arrow or linear effect, which shows the linear effect having one initial point and represented by the arrow are called polar vectors. Now, axial are which shows the rotational effect. Axial vectors are those vectors which shows the rotational effect. What do you mean by the rotational effect? Rotational effect means which are represented by rotation or circle like that. These are called the axial vector. Then how will you understand it? By example, you may easily understand. You may easily understand it. What are the axial and what are the polar? So, axial vectors are, suppose I am going to take the velocity omega. It is an angular velocity, torque, angular momentum, etc. So, these shows the rotational effect. It have a direction also. Direction as well as magnitude, but these show the rotational effect. So we are taking it into the category of axial vector. Omega, angular velocity, tau, torque, L, angular momentum. These are the what? Axial vector. So initially there are two types of vectors. One is polar vector, other is axial. I think you have to understand, guys. Now, I am going to classify it into various kinds. Initially, for understanding the vector, you have to understand modulus vector or magnitude of vector. First is modulus vector. Modulus vector. Modulus vector or magnitude of vector. So, what do you mean by the modulus? If you are writing any vector, suppose A vector is written in the form of mod. So, this is called modulus vector or mod A vector. Mod A vector means magnitude of vector. As you know that, magnitude of vector means what? Writing only 5. Getting it? Modulus vector, magnitude vector, if we are writing example, suppose 5 Newton force is over here. So, 5 Newton force, force is a quantity, magnitude is what? It is a 5. 5 is the magnitude over here. So, modulus vector is a magnitude vector. If any vector is represented in the form of like that, ax I cap plus ay j cap, A, Z, K, K. These are the component forms of vectors. AX is X-axis component. AY is Y-axis component. AZ is Z-axis component. And if you want to find the modulus vector of this vector A, then you will write it as mod of vector A is equal to A is equal to under root AX square plus AY square plus AZ square. So, this is the modulus vector. If you want to solve a numerical on this, so I am taking example, if A vector is 5i cap, 2j cap plus k cap, then finding for the modulus vector, that means mod of vector A, you will write it like that. 5 square means 25, 4 plus 1. AX square means 5 square. AY square means 2 square. AZ square means 1 square. Why? Because there is a 1 in this K cap. Magnitude is 1 over here. Magnitude is 2 over here. Magnitude 5. So, answer will become 25 plus 5 root 30. So, So root 30 will be the modulus of any vector quantity if it is written in the form of what? Components form. If it is diagrammatically represented, then this length will be the modulus vector. This length will be the modulus vector, which will represent by simply A, or whole vector will represent by A vector. Getting it? So one was the modulus. Now second is very important, that is unit vector. What is a unit vector? The vector having unit magnitude, the vector quantity or vectors having unit magnitude are called unit vector. It is represented by cap. See, A cap. Suppose a vector A is there here. So A cap is the representation of unit vector. If we are taking in the dimensional form, so suppose this is x axis, y axis and z axis. So I cap is a unit vector along x axis, j cap is a unit vector along y axis, k cap is a unit vector along z axis. Unit vector tells only the direction. It tells only direction of the vector. Only direction of the vector. It tells only direction. Cap tells only direction. So this I, j, k cap are the direction vectors along x axis, y axis or z axis. Magnitude of all the unit vectors remains same, that is unit. Unit means one. Okay, formula. A cap or unit vector of A is written as vector upon modulus of vector. This is the representation of A cap. A cap means unit vector of A, vector A upon modulus of vector A. If we are taking this example and you want to find the unit vector of this particular, so how will you find the unit vector? You know that vector is what? It is 5i plus 2j plus k, and modulus aapne kya find kiya tha? Root 30. So it will be root 30. You will write it like that, 5 upon root 30 I cap, 2 upon root 30 j cap, 1 upon root 30 k cap. So this will be what? This result will be the unit vector A cap of this example. So understand it. Two vectors are over here, modulus vector and unit vector. Okay guys, the third vectors, that is null vector. Null vectors. What are the null vectors? Null vectors or zero vectors, it is also called. It is represented by zero vector. Basic thing in this null vector is empty vector or null vector is what? Zero vector is what? The properties are the main over here. Is properties say J advance vagera mein bhi question aaya hai aur NEET vagera mein bhi aa sakta hai. So what are the three properties jo main bata raha hu? Properties to aur bhi hain, but main keval teen hi bata deta hu jisme se aapko clear ho jayega concept. So if we multiply any vector quantity with a null vector, it will become a null vector. Clear? If we add a null vector with any vector, there will be no change in the vector. If we multiply with a scalar, suppose lambda, with a null vector, there is no effect in the null vector. Now I am going to take one example. What what is the example over here? I am writing if a vector plus b vector is equal a vector minus b vector. ये condition possible कब है? When ये तभी possible है when b vector is a null vector. Getting it? If b vector is a null vector, then this will be equal to each other. Otherwise, this will not be equal. We will write is unequal. If b vector is a null, then this is correct. Okay, if b vector is not null, then we cannot write a vector plus b vector is equal to a vector minus b vector. This is a very important concept. Getting it? Now, I am going to tell you the fourth one. It is a proper vector. What are the proper vectors? Vectors except null vectors are called proper. Null vector को छोड़ करके जितने भी vectors हम पढ़ेंगे वो सारे के सारे vectors किस में आ जाते हैं बेटा? Proper vectors में. तो vector null को छोड़ दीजिए, बाकी जो भी vectors आगे पढ़ेंगे या पहले पढ़ लिए हैं वो सारे किस में आ जाएंगे? Proper vectors में. Now next one, fifth, equal vectors. If the magnitude and direction of two vectors, if the magnitude and direction of two vectors are same, then vectors are called equal vectors. Suppose vector A and vector B are equal. So we will say that the length of two vectors and the direction of two vectors will be same. Or magnitude of two vectors and the direction of two vectors will remain the same. Then we will say the vectors are equal vectors. Next one is opposite vectors or unequal vectors or negative vectors. Opposite, unequal or negative. Suppose opposite vector. Opposite vectors, fifth number. Opposite vectors are those vectors which have a same magnitude but direction is opposite to one another. See, these pair of two vectors are called opposite vectors. So A vector and B vector are equal but in minus. If we are writing inequality, then we'll take one in a minus. A and B are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. This is the representation of opposite vector. Now if you are writing like this A vector, this is a B vector, this is the representation A vector, B vector. If you want to draw the opposite vector of B, so you will draw the same length vector in opposite direction. So this will be negative vector of vector B. And if you want to draw the negative of A, then you will draw over here. So this is the representation by which we may understand the opposite vector or negative vector. Now, linear vector. Linear. Linear vectors. Vectors lying on the same line. If two or more vectors lie in the same line, then all vectors will said to be linear vectors. Getting it? Next is co-initial vector. Co-initial vectors. If vectors are starting from a common point then all vector will call as a co-initial. If the initial point is common, then we will say the vectors are initial, co-initial. Suppose I am taking over here vector A, vector B, vector C, vector D. If these all vectors are starting from a common point, then we will say it is a co-initial, vector A, vector B, vector C, vector D. Now, next one is coplanar vectors. Coplanar vectors, vectors lying on the common plane, same whiteboard, this, or कोई और भी मैं ड्रॉ कर देता हूं, कोई भी वेक्टर P, Q, R, कोई भी गिवन है इसमें, ऑल वेक्टर्स आर लाइन दिस कॉमन पर्टिकुलर व्हाइट बोर्ड आर कॉल्ड को प्लेनर वेक्टर्स. तो दीज आर द काइंड्स ऑफ द वेक्टर विच आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड ऑल काइंड्स. आई थिंक इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड इट देन वी विल गो अहेड for the operation of vectors. So there are three types of operation of vectors. Number one, two vector quantities can be added. So operation will be addition. Second operation is two vector quantity can be subtract. So subtraction of two vectors. And operation number three, product or multiplication. There are three types of operation are happening in the vectors. One is addition, subtraction, product. Addition, addition of two vector or more vector will be the concept. Subtraction, subtraction of two vectors or more. Product of two vectors. So product are two types. Over here, we will understand dot product and cross product. There are two types of product over here, but division is not possible. Why? Because the direction will not possible for division. So that's why division operation will not follow in the vector quantities. All the vector quantities, force, momentum, velocity, acceleration, have these properties, addition, subtraction and product, which will be understood.